Most of us were taught from an early age that a line is the shortest distance between two points. As it turns out, that statement is only partly true. The shortest distance between two points actually depends on the geometry of the object in question. For example, if we were living on a flat Earth, which we don't, then yes, a straight line would be the shortest distance between points A and B. However, the Earth is an approximate sphere, and the shortest distance between two points on the surface of a sphere is an arc known as the Great Circle Distance. People who have traveled by air have likely noticed that flights don't follow a direct path, but instead take a curved route to their destination. The curved routes are used because they're actually the shortest distance between those two locations on our planet. These curved routes are often confusing, as the routes are outlined on a flat, two-dimensional map, where a straight line might appear to be the shortest distance. However, a two-dimensional map of the Earth can never be entirely accurate. Earth is a three-dimensional space, and is best represented using a model globe. However, when one tries to flatten the sphere into a rectangular shape, as most maps do, the age-old dilemma of distortion arises. Most rectangular maps trade country shapes, sizes, intermediate distance, and even legitimate information for ease of understanding. On a globe, the shortest distance between New York and Paris would be an arc of roughly 3,630 miles. But the same arc, when projected on a 2D map, transforms into a straight line measuring approximately 3,750 miles. The difference between the two numbers, roughly 120 miles, may not seem like a big deal, but considering the fact that a Boeing 747 consumes an average of 5 gallons of fuel per mile in the air, the plane would require an additional 600 gallons for that extra distance, which would certainly add to the cost of plane tickets. In purely mathematical terms, a great circle is any circle drawn on a sphere whose center coincides with the center of the sphere, thus dividing the sphere into two equal halves. In simpler terms, a great circle is the largest circle that can be carved out of a sphere. A small circle, on the other hand, is when the centers of the circle and the sphere do not coincide. Imagine cutting the Earth along the equator or the poles. The resulting hemispheres would be equal, and the faces of these hemispheres would have the same diameter and center as the sphere itself. For any two non-diametrical points on a sphere, there exists only one unique great circle, whereas for diametrical points on a sphere, an infinite number of great circles can be drawn. These points divide the circle into two arcs. The smaller arc represents the true shortest distance between the two points and is called the great circle distance. However, even great circle distances do not represent the true shortest distance between two given locations. The great circle distances are calculated assuming Earth to be a perfect sphere, but the planet is more of a flattened sphere, with different radius values towards the equator and the poles. The great circle values therefore have a tolerance of about plus or minus 5%. Nevertheless, great circle distances have played a huge role in long-distance travel in recent decades, and will continue to do so, saving airlines fuel and saving travelers money.